This is terrorist firing at forces in the outskirts of Srinagar. Nazir with us. Nazir, tell us more.
Well, Sunil, there has been firing on security forces. It is a road opening party near Papur on the outskirts of Srinagar city. There were reports that there have been few injuries, but we are waiting for the confirmation from the officials. But officials have seen the police officials confirming that militants came from a marshy land area and they resorted to heavy firing on security forces. Groups repulsed the attack and it looks like militants have managed to escape. So this is third or the fourth attack in the same area in the last few months in which security forces have suffered casualties, but we are waiting for more details about this attack because this is a highly guarded highway where security forces, they are frequenting this area. There are security force convoys coming to that area, VIP movement as well. So despite being heavily guarded road, there has been this attack, which is a challenge for the security force, despite the claim that they have killed a large number of militants in the last 1 year and militancy is down. So we are initially trying to get more information if there have been any injuries or the casualties in this attack. But so far, police are saying no such details.
And Nazir, which area are we talking about here?
It's on the outskirts of Srinagar between Papur and Srinagar city. It's a highway where this attack has taken place. Highways, every highway is guarded by the security forces. It's army, it's CRPF, it's BSF who are guarding these roads here. Every inch of every step is being guarded by the forces. And despite that, militants managed attacks, resorted to heavy firing. As I said, police are saying they came from a marshy area. They took advantage of that area. Then they may have managed to escape after security forces repulsed the attack. Trying to get more details if there have been any casualties or the injuries in this attack.
And at roughly around what time did we get this information, Nazir? Also, I understand you only have, we don't have details of any injuries so far, but any number of terrorists which have been spotted in the area, the number that the forces are looking at?
Well, what the security forces are saying that there could have been two or three militants who may have attacked, resorted to firing. But the police are saying they don't have any details if anyone has been injured or died in this attack. But in attack itself is a huge challenge for the security force because it's happened at a place which is heavily guarded because this whole road is heavily guarded by the security force convoys passed through this area. And we have seen, if you see the Pulwama attack, last year it was the same highway which has always been the target of militants, despite being heavily guarded. But so far, good news is there has not been any report of casualty on the security force.
But does it sound like a case of shoot and scoot at this point? Nobody is under surveillance. Are they looking for these terrorists?
It's easier said than done when it comes to dealing with militancy, because militant is not something a criminal who comes and fires and then he can be caught. Militancy is a huge security structure which is dealing with militants in Kashmir. Sometimes they come and attack, and sometimes security forces go and seek militants and then during the encounters kill them. So it is a very, very complex subject. It is certainly a shoot and scoot. They fired and then they're taking the advantage of the area. This is a marshy land area and may have managed to escape. But security forces, they have laid the cordon. They are searching the area to track down the attackers.